Hey guys, VD Soundtrack Guy here, and this is just going to be my quick CyberPower PC 8-month follow-up. I've had this for about 8 months now, and tell you the truth, it's been doing great. When I first got this, because I actually kind of don't remember unboxing this all that time ago. I think it was May of 2014, I think. So I rewatched it, and I saw that I had complained or was worried about the power supply. I did some research on it, and to update you guys on that, the thing with the power supply is the reason I cannot find any specifications for it online is because apparently it's an in-house, it's manufactured in-house, which means CyberPowerPC actually made that power supply themselves with the help of Asa, and of course Asa put their label on that. Asa does not sell that power supply to the open public. It's just for CyberPowerPC, so that explains their listing. When I first bought my computer on their site, it said 800 watt, gold, 80 plus gold certified, whatever, power supply. I didn't know what kind I was going to get. So now, I suppose if that's the listing still even on there, available for customers now, currently, then I would suppose they get this as a power supply. But on the note of its functionality, it's been great. I went on some forums and I took a few snapshots of the performance and, all the voltages and rails and whatnot and all the technical specifications of what was going on with it. I took a snapshot of, what is that called? I think it's called CPU ID hardware monitor, HW monitor. And people say it's been running great. Just watch the voltages, make sure that the 12 volt doesn't go under 12 volt. Make sure the 3.3 volt doesn't go under, the specification it says, and it's been doing great. I would definitely do another follow-up video at the end of this year, 2015, because that would really give me, over a year, and I can definitely give even more feedback. But as for the power supply, it's been running great. Haven't had any problems with that, thank God, because I don't have the money to buy another 800 watt power supply. As for my original specifications, as of right now, they're still all in the play, except the core clock of my CPU. I believe it comes stock 3.5. It came stock. My AMD FX A320 came stock 3.5 gigahertz, and I overclocked it to a little over 4. I think it's like 4.1 or something like that. I don't know. But it's been stable, haven't had any problems, everything runs great. And sadly, when it comes to the note of my motherboard, because I have the motherboard box right up here, the Osius M5 A97 LE R2.0, sadly it only supports up to the 8370 in the FX line of CPUs, AMD CPUs. And I checked, I went on CPUBoss.com, I believe, or CPU Compare, whatever. It's a CPU comparison site, and I did the 8320 versus the top of the line for what this motherboard can support, the 8370, and there's like zero difference. So I'd be wasting money buying the 8370, so just clock it a little over 4, and I'll be good. I don't need to buy no 8350. Or whatever you call it, the 8350, the 8370, whatever. I don't need to buy any of that stuff. Just keep the CPU I got right now, and as long as it's overclocked, at least to 4, I should be good. As for my graphics card, that's still running fine. No problems there. Heating and stuff is great. But I'm not even sure if I did an unboxing for this or anything like that. But as for my air cooler, I threw that out a long time ago. Sadly, I live in West Virginia. The reason I say sadly, I'm not making a 7-hour video going to each and every single thing, the disadvantages of living here. But anyways, this room, this house in general was old, and the pictures you're about to see here of my computer, which still is great. I like the little blue LED on the front. That's real nice. But as for my room, sadly, the carpet is old. And I cannot keep this room dust-free for 3 days tops. I can't. So you might see dust on the case and everything. It isn't bad to where it's like layered, thick dust. But it gets dusty a lot. Everything I touch now is dusty and stuff like that. And the only reason to fix this is to pull the carpet up and put down some hardwood flooring. We do the same with our kitchen, and it's wonderful now in there. But I know it would be a thousand times better in here when it comes to dust and airflow, which is what I want to get on now. I did remove that CPU fan because I couldn't even run the computer for 2 days to install updates and to install the OS and everything, because that air cooler, it wasn't doing it. My idle temp was 80. That's, oh my lord, that's terrible. So I went online, and then people were also talking about online, which by the way, if you know you know something, and someone tells you otherwise, then just don't listen to them, because I went on PC forums, and I told them my situation, and they were like, just get a different air cooler. No, the air in here is hot. Actually, my room, until recently, thankfully, but it used to be my room would be the temperature of the outside, not the exact temperature, but pretty close. So during summer times, it's roasting in here. During winter time, like now, I'm actually pretty okay because it's freezing outside. And, you know, it's better for a computer to be cold than to be hot. But anyways, yeah, it was, I went on PC forums, told people about that, and they're like, get a different air cooler. So what I did was I saw what liquid coolers were good for my computer, and I believe I got the Cooler Master Sidon 120XL. The XL just means it has a fan for the front of the radiator in the back. And I've been installing it, and it's been great. Been getting great temps. Been putting heavy load on it, and it doesn't go up. The max it goes on is 60C now. So it's great. Like I said, don't ever let anyone tell you any different. If you know your surroundings or whatever, I knew air cooling wouldn't do it. Actually, right now, because of the heat, the air is hot. So if I were to have this straight air cooler, my CPU would be on fire. But it's pretty good. So the only upgrades I got from my unboxing video is just liquid cooler. Now what I'm planning on doing is once they get some money, and I don't really foresee me getting as much money as I need for all these upgrades total. But I would say probably at the end of 2015, I plan on having 32 gigabytes of RAM, and unless someone sways me into another direction, or unless a new graphics card comes out that's even better than the one I'm planning on getting the, I think it's the XFX R9 290X 8 GB edition. I know they have the 4 GB, but I thought to myself, man, I play a lot of these games, and it's taxing on the GPU's VRAM. So if I get a better graphics card, shoot, I can max everything out. You know, all my old games were at the highest resolution possible on my current card, which is, because I don't remember these names, forgive me, but it is the AMD R9 272 GB. So, you know, and I know 2 GB is pretty low. I know someone said if you got 4 GB, you'd be fine. I thought to myself, for the price of the R9 290X, 8 GB edition, which is $475. That's a steal for 8 GB. That's a steal. I had to omit that from my current budget. Cause I will be getting some money here soon, and this channel is gonna be getting a lot of good content here soon because of that. But anyways, I had to omit that from the budget. It was a budget cut. But here sooner or later, if no one releases anything else equivalent to that, I'm going to go ahead and take it. I know people are going to say, oh, you know, that's way too expensive here, and that's overkill for getting, you know, 8 GB. But I thought to myself, I would have plenty of headroom. Now, why ever use that whole 8 GB? No. In fact, I've read that the only way I will is if I had a dual monitor setup, which this monitor just barely fits on this desk, so that's not happening. But if I were to have a dual monitor setup and run iFinity and, like, run, like, Shadow Mode or something like that, you know, 4K and stuff like that, and then that's when I get all the you know, gigabytes. But I thought to myself, it's pretty good to have good headroom, you know what I'm saying? Because 4 GB, you're always just gonna push it. You're gonna push it. Where 8 GB, you'll have, you know, you'll push your games to the max with more gigabytes or a VRAM to expend. So, you know, I thought it was a good deal. That's just me. But, yeah, that's it. I plan on, I really hope I have, I do fulfill what I want to do and get 32 gigabytes of RAM, because I do a lot of heavy stuff on here. Not only for school, my own personal projects, and 32, like I said, that headroom, always good to have a lot of headroom. So, 32 gigabytes of RAM, and that AMD R9 290X 8 gigabyte edition from FXF. That's hard to say real fast. Those are the upgrades I plan on getting. But other than that, short and sweet, the rig's been just fine. All the videos you've seen since that unboxing have been using, you know, my webcam hooked into this computer. So everything's been fine. I had zero problems. The only problems I've had is on my end, viruses, etc., etc. So do I recommend CyberPowerPC? Yes. Another thing I want to mention, too, is that I really appreciated their professional wiring option, because the case I have, which is the only name I actually remember of my hardware components, is the Thermaltake S21. The biggest con and the biggest drawback from all the reviews I've seen on this is cable management. Terrible, terrible, terrible cable management. But I give my props to CyberPower, because I'm not very good at cable management myself. For this setup, this whole rig here, it looks pretty good. But as for like a computer, I'd be terrible. But their team did such a good job putting zip ties and tucking things in here and then there. And I really have to give them their props, because I know if I would have done it myself, it would look like terrible. But considering how horrible the cable management is for the S21, and considering the excellent job CyberPower did with what they had, you know, doing the cable management, I think that little extra, $50 max for that professional wiring option when you buy the rig, it was worth it. And they did a great job. I can really get in that computer and work. I have lots of airflow, lots of space. If I need to install new parts, I just follow the wiring that they already set up and keep it like that. I think they did a very good job. So, thank you very much, CyberPower, for that. And all in all, 8 months in, do I recommend CyberPower PC? Yes. But be careful, because like I said, in this day and age, maybe back in the day, they were all like DOAs, dead on arrivals. But right now, I can say that it's a hit and miss. It's a hit and miss. So, you know, you got to pray. You got to do whatever you do, whatever you believe in. Do that. And hopefully your rig comes to you good. Mine did. So I'm satisfied. Very, 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 very satisfied. It's a great investment. And it still amazes me the fact that when I go on that canyourunit.com, I see if I can play today's latest games. And although I can't max them out, at least I can play them. You know, I'm used to running max on my old rig, 800 by 600. And that's max resolution I could run. And the graphics card I had was integrated. It was onboard NVIDIA graphics. It was terrible. And I had 2 gigabytes of RAM. You know what I'm saying? So it's great, you know, to have that, to have all that, you know, that power and stuff like that, and for it to be upgradable. Because the old one I had, my old rig was a slim PC. It was literally like you could fit it in your book bag, and there'd still be room. It's a slim PC. Whereas this is actually still considered a pretty small PC. Because I've seen some big ones recently. I saw a Mass Effect tower. Oh my lord! You see how high this keyboard I have right here is? It's higher than that. I'm like, my God, how do you guys fit those huge rigs in your house? Full tower cases. I can't do that mess. But I like it. It works. It's just great. As you saw by the photos, the case just fits inside of the opening I have in this PC desk. So it's great. You know, it's great to have this little PC space. I got my printer, my computer, my monitor, and you know, you guys are looking at me with the webcam right now. So it's great. I recommend CyberPower PC. It's a hit and miss, so you gotta be able to take a risk. You know, gotta be able to take a risk. But if everything works out for you, if the dice roll in your favor, good for you. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. VD Soundcheck, guys, signing out. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later.